Nope, it's not a UFO. It actually says on the back and on my side too, harmless weather instrument. This is a radio sonde, a balloon-borne instrument used by the National Weather Service to obtain weather data aloft for weather forecasts and research. It is not dangerous. Please dispose of properly. My name is Brandon Rubinostra. I'm a lead forecaster at the National Weather Service here in Sterling, Virginia. Overall, we focus on protecting lives and property through severe weather warnings. But besides that, we also just issue your regular forecasts you'll see at our website, weather.gov. So we do a weather balloon launch twice a day. So in daylight time, we issue at 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. local. So when time comes to do the weather balloon launch, I need to fill up the balloon with hydrogen. And then from there, it like inflates for about 12 to 14 minutes. And at that point, I'll get together all the materials, the parachute, and the radio sign, including unpackaging it. And the data we collect with this instrumentation really enhances the production of our forecasts. Weather model is basically just a little fancy way of predicting what the weather's gonna do. It takes in all the math and physics and it spits it out onto your computers where you can look at the weather information in a very simple way. We have the balloon, which is about 4 to 5 feet in diameter by the time it inflates fully, which takes about 12 to 14 minutes. And then below that, we have about 70 to 80 feet of string, and that will go to the actual radio sonde. So we get this information through radio waves. We're able to get the information as it goes up back to our radar here, which will then get us that information real time into our computers. And we get information about every second or two. Everyone growing up wants to be something, and I always wanted to be a meteorologist, not only because I find the weather fascinating, but also to help people. So all the times you watch TV and see something scrolling across the screen, tornado warning, severe thunderstorm warning, it may annoy someone, but your reality, we're helping people. We're helping people take cover. These balloons, all the information we get from radars, all these things together help us do that mission.
If you could launch your own weather balloon, what kind of data would you want to collect? Let us know in the comments section. And if you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.